Good afternoon, guys. So we'll now discuss the current affairs, what happened in the last week. We'll look at the last week, the major topics, few have to do with international relations, science and technology, and certain series of events like the solar archer, the US satellite, rover sent to sun nearest orbiter, and that's completed a series of time. Similarly, with the other aspects of the local, certain schemes and policies, we'll try to focus on them. Okay, the question talks about what? Magnetospheric multiscale mission, which investigates how the sun's and earth's magnetic fields connect and disconnect, is an initiative by which among the following? What's the answer? NASA. Hope you have a clarity about the statement, what it is asked. Is speaking about what? Magnetospheric. Certain magnetic field, multiscale mission. So how to understand this energy? You look at in the solar system, you know that there is a vacuum. If there is a vacuum, then definitely what only passes is a radiation. Rest all kind of electromagnetic radiation are now going to be weak. It is believed that certain energy sources are also available, because it is certain forces are creating, and because of the radiation, there is a chance of creating electromagnetic. When there is electric energy, definitely, as per as remember, there is a theory called Fleming's thumb rule like this. Okay, so the presence of electric energy will also lead to what? Creation of magnetic field. And there is a magnetic field, definitely it also can throw some light on the Big Bang theory. So this is more about what applied physics, if you observe. The magnetospheric multiscale mission, which investigates how the sun's and earth's magnetic field connect and disconnect, is an initiative by which among the following? Hope you know that on earth we have magnetic fields, yes or no? Normally we have at the poles, north pole and the south pole. Similarly, when the sun, inside the sun, there is going to be always nuclear fission or fusion. So which release more energy, fusion or fusion?
Fusion.
Hydrogen bomb is more powerful than atom bomb. Okay, so what happens is that in a fission, a single part is going to be fission, multiple parts. Fusion is that creation of that. So-called hydrogen particles combine to form helium, fusion aspect. Helium is going to be further divided, called helium, hydrogen. So when this a continuous process happens in the sun, that leads to certain solar energy emission. And this is what you call solar flares. What do you call them? Solar. You'll learn in the next week, next month, in the geography, what is a solar flare. And now, as this the law of thermodynamics says that heat flows from the hot body to cold body. So this is going to be a very series of time. That means on a certain any point of time, you're going to see certain dark spots. These are called what? Sunspot. These are called sunspots. So this also relate to kind of a magnetic energy. And when the solar flares are coming near to Earth, what happens? Tell you speaking, it should burn the atmosphere areas, but because of the presence of what? Poles. These carrying electromagnetic, they will be attracted by poles, and that will lead to what in the northern, you look at lights, what do you call them? Borealis refers to north, Australis means south. In this way, you're going to see the light. So definitely, my friend, a shift in or a change in the magnetic field created by the electric field is going to create a change in the Earth's, we can say in the totality, in the atmosphere presence. And it also can help us understand how this Big Bang theory can be understood. Because if you observe the magnetic field, you might have seen the movie called 2012. Clear? The presence is so huge that you're going to see in the end of the movie that the poles are going to be twisted. So when the poles are shifting, that clearly shows that entire telecommunication also going to be affected. So it's a very wide aspect in applied physics. So what's the answer, by the way? Now, sir, it can help you also to understand in the SNT. Possibly Vinay sir is going to cover that in the detail for you. Okay? Yeah. Here comes the next drug. What's the drug called? Pretomanid. Pretomanid, a drug recently seen in the news, is used to treat which among the following disease? What's the disease? Nipah virus, Zika virus, tuberculosis, petrosis. What's the disease, guys? At least you didn't do the homework. Okay, sir, I will take. Do it. Do the Google. What's the drug called? Pretomanid. It was news in little. It was news in little. Can you tell me the company that discovered it? Read and tell me. Why are you guessing? Read and tell me. What is the company? What's the company name?
TB Alliance.
It belong to which country? It belong to which country? Loudly.
It was founded in South Africa. And has expanded. Headquarters in
New York City. Clear? So it is actually, when you look at the developing countries and especially Africa and India, so-called the biodiversity countries, they are suffering with a huge tuberculosis, my friend. And do you remember the WHO target to eliminate the tuberculosis, what's the year?
2020.
Are you sure? You should always remember the malaria, TB. These are target years are equally important. They already asked the exam questions. So was the target year recently updated now? We want to do it prior only. What is the target for malaria then? This is already asked in group 1 exam question in Andhra Pradesh. So when you try to learn a subject, don't try to blindly by heart the facts. Know the story behind that one. Clear? So the story over here is that India has come up its own kind of drugs called multi-drug therapy. What is multi-drug therapy, by the way? TB, the biggest challenge is, you know, TB is what? Is that a protozoa or virus or bacteria? It's a bacteria.
Microbacterium.
Okay. So, the bacteria is getting resistant to the drugs what all we are using. One, because of the no proper drug is happening. Like I say, in our country, the TB is prevalent. Openly speaking, it's very prevalent. Because one of the major reasons, because of the conditions prevailing, and the also aspect about the cooking fuel in the village, if you observe, the LPG is not present. So, they're forced to know what to do. They use a charcoal. Use the charcoal kind of a stove. All this is adding what? Respiratory issues. So, they come to the primary health centers and they'll be giving a basic drug. Single monodrug therapy initially. But that's not going to function. Initially, he'll be using for 2 to 3 days. And later on, he stopped using. And what happened to the bacteria? It's going to be resistant to that drug. And that lead to what? Multi-drug therapy. But year after year, if you observe, India is spending a lot of money to eradicate this TB process. One of the reason over here is to, because is the TB an epidemic disease or not? It's an epidemic, my friend. So, it actually passes from a person to person through the fluid. Like, when you talk, this might be of kiss, by the way. It might be of using. That's why we expect those people to cover the mouth doing it. It has been a very prevalent, especially about pregnant women, if you ask me. almost you take about among the 100, I think there is about 2 to 3 women, they were exposed to this tuberculosis. The child is also getting infected about the TB. Are we clear? And this has been a big concern. Why? Because India, somehow we have our own kind of aims. They have come with a pentavalent drug. It's a very interesting drug. The pentavalent drug is a combination of five major drugs combined together called pentavalent drug. But this is what unable to address the issue rightly. So we are relying on the other countries. And you know about the drugs, if you observe, TRIPS is come to picture over here. So when it comes to intellectual property rights, that whenever you have getting recognized, so if they file the patents, then we supposed to buy that products. And that's also been in use for a while. So especially to look at the countries so-called Africa, India, and also in the Sri Lanka. These are biodiverse countries. So it's been used for a while, little, so you have to be careful. Okay? I hope we had earlier learned it, right? So if that's a virus, something then it's going to be end with what? Something like vir. Drug is going to be ending with the vir. So, what is this pertussis, by the way? Pertussis, what's the disease? Whooping cough. I believe it's whooping cough. Check it. Question number 3 talks about what? Nishtha. What is Nishtha with reference to Nishtha, National Innovation, Innovative for School Heads and the Teacher Holistic Advancement? Consider the following statements. So the topic is clearly about what? HRD, Human Resource and Development Aspect. It's been launched to improve learning outcomes at the elementary level. It's to motivate and equip teachers to encourage and foster critical thinking in students. It is an initiative of MHRD. So what's the answer, by the way? If you observe in our country, there was actually, even today there was an article in the Hindu paper, not article, it's about education column. Why the innovation is not going high in our country? Number one, in the urban areas compared to rural areas, guess where the innovation is high? Urban or rural? Urban. The answer is simple, because in rural we have capital deficit. I forget about capital, technology, there is no electricity at all. At least in southern states we are far better, we have a good availability of electricity. When you look at the states like Odisha, Bihar, even Uttar Pradesh, there are many states still they are not covered, completely electrified. In fact, it's good to scheme, that is a scheme, what is the scheme called? 100% electrification of India by 2019, all the villages. Saubhagya scheme. There was one of the successful campaign happened in the India 2 period. Officially, government announced that there is a village where got already 100% electrified. So when I say the word village, it has to be very clear. Are you referring to hamlets also? The answer is may not be. Which are having registered under panchayats. So, point to be noted. So, technology is not there. Basically, and the very worst part over here is that the teachers who are in the village areas are not empowered with the innovative ideas. Because who are going to go to village? People who have less skill, openly speaking, less skill. And the skill they deliver to the others, and that's how they make the living. People who are in the AIIMS and IITs, they have no real agenda to go to village areas and show their innovation. So one or the other way, there is a restriction. In fact, as college will take up as a part of the project work. A project work is like an assignment that you deliver, but that's not going to fulfill the gaps. Clear? So scheme is going to be a very important one. It's called Nishtha. Question number 4 talks about what? Sulfur dioxide. Hope you know about what is a sulfur cycle. Huh? Sulfur cycle. What is a sulfur cycle? Atmosphere too? Take in fact the presence. You look at atmosphere. The atmosphere component, we have the sulfur, by the way. In fact, you take any organism, it's any flora or fauna, it is a sulfur component only. Clear? Hope you remember the NPK. Nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and also these are called micronutrients. Macronutrients and micro going to be also sulfur, boron, molybdenum, magnesium, they're going to be all part of it. The biggest challenge is that this sulfur is going to be even under inside the soil. If you observe, they'll be in the form of sulfates. The sulfur is going to be taken in the form of, you take all the proteins, what all you use. Proteins consist of, by the nature, sulfur. Proteins. Look at the onion, by the way. When you cut the onion, why you get tears? Because, answer is simple. sulfur meets with the air and that will lead to the tear glands come. So sulfur is a part in everywhere, my friend. It's a part of everywhere. So how this sulfur is going to come back to earth is going to be a challenging one. Recently, there is an association called Greece NGO, Green Peace. This has come with a document that India is the highest release of anthropogenic sulfur, human creation. Sulfur by nature is common. Like it comes with what? Volcanic eruption, boom. Everywhere you see sulfur. Agreed on that one? So apart from that, you create the sulfur. Why? How? Mining. Mining process. Mining will lead to what? Certain release of the energy, certain release of the chemicals, and especially about what? Copper mining. No, copper. Copper is, what is the raw form of copper?
Bauxite.
Bauxite?
Copper.
Where do you see copper? At the high levels or lower levels only? The highest only. Cuprum you are going to find it, okay? So the aspect of the copper is more, when you start mining it, it will not aggregate in the form of what? Sulfates. So that's why, please remember, copper is not highly available. I think it's going to be available in the CaSO4, I believe. Copper sulfates. So it will be in the form of what?
Copper pyrites.
Normally you call CaSO4, I believe. CaSO4. Yes. Copper sulfates. You know, I said sulfur will be in the, and a sulfur is a metallic or non-metal? Yeah. Non-metal. It's a molecule, by the way. So it has to be the combination, reactive. So copper sulfate. That lead to what? When you mine it, sulfur will release it. So mining is also creating a big tragedy over here. There's at least one question in the UPSC. They ask you about any cycle, nitrogen cycle, or oxygen cycle, or sulfur cycle, carbon cycle, any cycle. So read all the environmental ecology NCERTs properly. And when this sulfur is getting in the atmosphere, now see what is going to happen. These are having a very big molecule in structure, so they're going to be a part of what? PM, that's what you call particulate matter. Particulate matter. This particulate matter is going to be like water covering the entire, and that will be part of what do you call that? Ozone depleting sources, ODS. You look at ODS, but what are the elements in ODS? What are the gases in ODS, by the way? Nitrous oxide. Water vapor, sulfur dioxide. So CH4. CFC, CU, CO, carbon dioxide. Monoxide is a air quality index, AQ. I think it's not carbon dioxide, na? Monoxide, AQ. It's carbon dioxide, I believe. I check it. Monoxide is a, monoxide you're going to see in the lower level, I believe, not the higher level. Unburnt carbon dioxide is what you call carbon monoxide. Ozone depleting source is carbon dioxide. No? It's called greenhouse gas also, right? And by the way, carbon monoxide is very reactive. So there is no scope of carbon monoxide going to be available in the atmosphere for a long time. Dioxide monoxide?
Still.
Ozone depleting sources. Or also get GHG gases. Greenhouse gases.
Greenhouse gases and ODS are different.
They are different.
CO2 is a greenhouse gas. Mm-hmm. Does it? And one more thing is, ozone to deplete, that should be highly reactive.
Reactive gas. With the logic here. Yes. Okay, just check it now if possible. Yes. Fine. So when this carbon dioxide, when this
ozone is ozone depleting gas.
Ozone is reactive now, O3. So what it needs a highly reactive gas. Obviously, what happens like the chlorine. You look at the aspects here, helium, chlorine, argon, these are what you call highly reactive. Inert gases, sir, what are we talking? Noble gas, I mean, not even gas, noble gases. Okay, so when you look at the carbon dioxide, what happens? The biggest challenge about this is what? Burning of fossil fuel. Fossil is always combination of what? Carbon And the presence is always what? Sulfur dioxide and nitrous oxide also. Yeah.
CO2 is indirectly involved. How is it that CO2 traps the heat in the troposphere?
The ozone is in the stratosphere.
So, what happens is when these molecules go outside, it creates favorable conditions for the reaction. So you
see that fact in the Wikipedia, if I'm not wrong, you'll say, see your explanation. So, carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is not a reactor, but it turns into stratosphere, it becomes a odious gas. Yeah, I've been a long time I have referred that. Okay, then comes a volcanic activity. Obvious, yes or no? What is called the kings of acid?
King of
are we clear? So definitely we can't escape the word called volcanic activity. Yeah, so it is not in ozone in the troposphere, right? It's strato, I think it's going to be.
It creates favorable conditions.
So it depends on us. Only chlorofluorocarbons, hydrochloroplasts,
hydrochloroplasts, carbons, methyl bromide.
Okay, then possibly I've said that. So it's not odious, I suppose to say greenhouse gases then. I should say GHG gases then. Okay, I'm so sorry about it. So in GHG gases, we have nitrous oxide and sulfur dioxide. And in the sulfur dioxide, when it reaches atmosphere, what happens? They meet with the clouds and behaves like what? What do you call them? A place where the cloud can reach the condensation. What do you call that? They need a place. The solid particles, the microscopic nuclei, hydroscopic nuclei. So what happens? It will be more reactive and that will lead to condensation. Now the sulfur meeting with the water droplets will turn into what? Acid rains. So the acid rains are also going to create what? Number one, a damage to the heritage. Number two, also it's going to attack the aquatic life. Almost all there. Hope you know about why the Taj Mahal. Here Taj Mahal, we don't do the same. Not allowed the vehicles to also do that. Lot of effect. Byproduct of copper extraction. Now this is something you need to have a clarity. If you know very widely that copper sulfate is going to be widely seen combination. Copper sulfate. So when you mine it, possibly you're going to find it in the extraction form also. Clear? So these are challenging questions for you. It's about environment come chemistry questions. One question you can expect this way, sir. Last year, there were about 2 to 3 questions about them. Because you write India belong with the Indian Forest Service.
Answer is 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
How? That's the release of sulfur dioxide, sir. That 1 line 3 is anthropogenic release, no? It has to be only 2.
Burning of fuel, okay. Fossil fuel.
Byproduct of copper.
Volcanic activity, anthropogenic. Okay, by extraction. Okay, he's asking natural, no? I'm so sorry. The answer has to be what? It's a mining process, not byproduct of extraction. So these are anthropogenic. This is what? I'm so sorry. Yeah, thank you. Question 5 talks about what debenture redemption reserve. What is this debenture, by the way? Debentures.
It's a bond.
It's a bond given by the company having its proper goodwill, faith in the market. So if you want to give company market, what they're going to do, they're going to give this instrument. It's a debt instrument. So pay me some money, after some period of time I can give you either what? In the form of assured. Whether you want to have a certain amount that I promise you, you can take it, or you can take it in the complete redemption way. But the challenge over here is that, you know, Harshad Mehta scam, Sahara scam. The Sahara scam, what is his name, by the way?
Subrata Rai.
What, why he was arrested, by the way? Because he used debenture to tackle the market. Normally in debentures, you'll be having a two kind of debentures. Either priorly you have to intimate it, either you can take the cash form or you can take in the share form. But he gave a chance to people like optional debentures. Optional something, at that time whatever you feel comfortable, you can do it. Now this is something very attractive. So there is no binding on the customers that you should definitely take in the form of a money, in the money form or in the share market form. Now, that is the case actually. He was arrested and later on proved that these are about a Ponzi schemes involved in that. Story is going to be later on. The challenge now is what called a debenture redemption scheme. Why? Why it was in news now? What do you mean by redemption? Shashank redemption.
Sir,
What is redemption, by the way? Redeem. To safeguard, to renew that, to create safer side. Reserve is something that you create space to better function. Like whenever.
I think redemption is claiming back.
Claiming, redeeming.
Whatever we invested,
redeeming back. What happens is normally a company like me, let's imagine if I have a company and I want to release my debentures. Strictly, I can't do that. What government says is that maintain some reserve in case you default. At least from the reserves, we can compensate that. Now, this led to what certain more investments supposed to be diverted to here. That means, for example, let's say I got a 10 crore rupee. It is said that closely at that time 50% supposed to be redemption. But now it was reduced to what 10%. And that too for a few government entities like what? The housing banking, house banking areas where more welfare supposed to be created. Now they have cancelled recently that reserve. That means whatever the government is now doing, whatever the any entity, like any private or a government, if that's a private, from 50% they reduce to what 10%. That means the burden on the company to maintain more reserve is diluted. This can have a positive aspect and also negative aspect. Positive something, this will make every people to come and do the business. So even at the grassroots level, you can draw the money. Secondary market. The negative aspect is that risk is more high here. It is a required imposed on the Indian corporation that issued debentures. Requirement imposed on Indian corporation that issued debentures. Debentures are backed by an asset. There is no backing, my friend. There is no backing of any collateral security, nothing. This is why whenever a company fails, all you can do is that you are going to take a risk. Clear? So this is something very important. It is not backed by any asset or loan or any other form of collateral. That's a major difference between, there's a term actually called deposit insurance. Only banks can provide you deposit insurance, nothing else.
Deposit insurance and credit guarantee.
That's a body, my friend. That's a body, by the way. But deposit insurance is not an aspect of debentures. Highly risky nature. Better than shares, but worse than the banking facility, what you call. So second is a wrong statement. First is right. Basically, they will be asking you some very standard questions only. Question number 6 talks about what? Mission Chandrayaan 2. Is successful or failure? What do you call that? In the words of Israel, it is partially successful. In the words of Congress, if you say, it's a failure, by the way. 98% success, what you call, still it is. India is supposed to be the fourth nation after US, EU, I believe, China and India. Supposed to be, but the accidental landing of the rover and a crash led to what situation. So why it was in news, by the way? It is the first space mission to conduct a soft landing on the moon's south polar region, right or wrong? Yes. What's the difference between the soft landing and hard landing? Hard landing is crash, sudden. Especially it has nothing with the rover. If there is a rover, it's supposed to be a soft landing. And soft landing is, you learn in the S&T that not possible in the southern polar, south pole easily. Because of the shift of the gravity, one reason. It is the Indian mission to explore the lunar terrain with the homegrown technology. In fact, the reason for mission is not only that, have many other aspects. Even it is said that by the news that even there are some kind of a nuclear energy also present in that. So you can even extract that, the story about it. Clear? So it is the first countries ever to soft land on the first, okay? No, it is a fourth country supposed to be prosperly, but it was a failure one. So what's the answer?
1 and 2.
Yes. Then question talks about what energy resource efficiency policy. Draft on national resource efficiency policy. Please remember there is something called energy resource efficiency, RE. Widely news, my friend. Widely news. What is resource efficiency? Please remember by nature. When you look at the many concept of sustainable development, I think the SDG 6 talks about that efficiently utilizing. So proper utilization of it. We have normal resources which are very, very deficient in nature, and we supposed to use them very effectively. How you can do that effectively? By using certain technology aspects, green technology, proper management of it, clear. And it's also known as common sharing. Sharing of the resources, all this is going to be part of it. Initially, in the year 2017 itself, India government has come with a tied up with the EU, Europe Union. And among the Europe Union countries, if you observe the first, or in my opinion, as per my statistics knowledge, I know Germany is the first country to utilize the resource in a very efficient way. And you know the which is a European country now shifting completely towards the solar energy, slowly going away from the nuclear energy? It is Germany. You look at a Germany buildings, almost it's guaranteed that you need to have a rooftop or solar panels, definitely. So we have recently tied up, just a couple of weeks back only, we have tied up with the Germany in drafting a policy, how better the policy making can also create what energy efficient, resource efficiency. And energy efficiency is one is a part of that one. We have something called a B, you know that, what is B stands for?
Energy efficiency.
So, it doesn't matter what kind of resource we are talking, we need some kind of a way, certain policy to have certain efficient aspects. Definitely, it's what you can say, it needs a lot of research and development. Do you know a technology called nanotechnology? Any idea? What is this nanotechnology about? Nano.
10 power minus 9.
10 power minus 9 is called nano. Okay, what is this nanotechnology then?
Nanoparticles.
Exactly how the nanoparticles going to function. You know, nanoparticles are going to be much more efficient than the microparticles if you observe. In how very, very stable in one way, it can be used in very aspects. The best example I can give is frequently seen use. Like if at all you make an air flight, especially engine in the plane, that normally makes a sound. And you know what is that sound called? It's called knotting. K-N-O-T-T-I-N-G, knotting. Which is very, very problematic. And if that is not controlled properly, that also going to damage the plane. So, if at all it is said that if you make engine with the nanoparticles, then it's going to reduce that. Clear? Even the robotics, you're going to use the nanotechnology, my friend. Is that energy efficiency or not? Resource efficiency or not? That's a point to be noted. Clear? Even certain nanoparticles are also induced in the human body. So possibly too, because certain times what happens, the veins are going to be blocked. So these nanoparticles are going to be used as like pressure, so that be used. All these are what one or the other way, the effective ways of using the energy resources. Clear? So it's a widely important topic, very, very important topic in the science and technology, engineering, mathematics, sorry, in the physical aspect, in the physics. Clear? It is drafted by Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Obviously, it has to be what? Definitely energy efficiency. It plans to offer tax benefits on recycled materials, green loans to small entrepreneurs. So, if at all you want to create energy efficiency, it should start from bottom up approach. So, right from the beginning onwards, start creating what? Renewable energy sources. Do you remember there is something called differential rate of interest? There is something also called as a primary sector lending, RBA. RBA will give directions to the banks, asking them to give certain lower rate of interest to certain sectors like renewable energy was recently included in that. So that kind of policy will definitely will have what effect on the energy efficiency. And for a country like India is definitely needed. Do you know this plant called Zatropha? Shabash. Biodiesel, by the way. Diesel is a dirty industry, yes or no? It's a dirty, new to externality. It's going to damage the environment very badly. So when you can replace that Zatropha plant with this biodiesel, is going to benefit a lot also. Clear? So, the government is funding also such kind of biodiesels. Look at the South America. Almost all the vehicles are made up of what? Ethanol engines only. Not because they have a sugar cane and the bagasse they can be used later on. The companies like Ford also make engines what? Based on the biodiesel. Based on ethanols. Why it is not happening in India? Tell me. Why we can't make engines on this one? Policy, because of all the MPs and MLAs, they have very big petrol bunks. So, they want to, this is seriously a big challenge, my friend. So, energy efficiency happens when there is a ground level focus. That should be great. E-vehicles, if you observe, even that can be also part of called resource efficiency. So, it plans to offer what? Tax benefits. So, definitely you will be happy. It aims for moving towards a zero landfill approach in the country. What is zero landfill?
Zero
Google that. Zero landfill. It is now newly the environment economic topic. Yeah. So it is kind of creating an environment where rather than dumping it or badly doing it, almost all the developed countries are now going for this zero landfill, because zero landfill is a mechanism, I believe. Can you check it? Where the garbage can be reduced in a go, like a reuse, recycle. Clear? Reuse, recycle.
It supports the redesign of the resource life cycles, so that the maximum value
can be
from that resource.
Can be maximum utilized from that resource. The best example, you know, glass. You know how long it takes plastic to get completely, what do you call that term? Degradable. How long it takes? And you know that glass takes more than plastic. Glass takes more than, how much paper takes? Paper. Days. Not days, I think it's in the months. It's supposed to be in months. So these are areas by there. So it is moving towards what, zero landfill approach in the country. So one or the other way, we also have a target, right? What is called a solid waste management. Okay, it also can be fixed to this one. And this is what? 1, 2, 3. The question talks about now called Indian Resource Panel. With reference to Indian Resource Panel established by the Government of India, consider the following statements. An advisory body. Obviously, remember, panel is advisory body. Panel is an advisory body. Okay? Panel under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Okay, it is supported by Indo-US bilateral cooperation. It is, by the way, it is Indo-US only cooperation. One of the very few pacts, if you observe, that's between India, not few actually, with respect to what? Environment. India and US environment pacts are very few. Very, very few. You take other countries, possibly we had a good with Europe Union, we had with especially with the US and Russia, we have very few environmental, like a nuclear fuel. If you observe, these are very environment damaging. You import maximum missiles, weapons, that damaging environment aspect only here. So it is supported by Indo-US bilateral cooperation. It is something that how a panel has to be created and how effectively that. Same aspect here, the benefit, how better that the two bilateral relations can be strengthened by effectively utilizing the resources. It's also called a confidence building measures, CBM, certain joint ventures, JV, etc. What's the answer? Then talks about a Birshit mission, second time we are talking about it, if I'm not wrong. What is Birshit mission, by the way? Israel moon mission. Israel moon mission, by the way, they want to also try. Just in fact, it tried before the Chandrayaan 2 mission. They also had this organism. Remember, what is that organism called? They have sent their organism so that which can survive in the extreme cold conditions, extreme hot conditions also. What's that called? Tardigrade, something like that. Name is going to be Tardigrade. Just find it. So it is about a moon mission by Israel. So, it was a very, what is a Birshit by the way in the Israeli language, if you observe? Beginning. So, they want to begin the, yes, but that was a failure aspect. What's that organism called? Targets.
T space ARBIGRADS. Water webs.
Very ugly looking organism, by the way. Don't look it.
Tardigrades.
Tardigrades, okay. T A Tati, right? Okay. Fine. Question number 10 talks about legislative councils. You know very well the story about it. What's the story about legislative councils? Remember, though we have 28 states in our country, not all states have bicamerals. What do you mean by bicameral? Two houses. In India, we have parliament. Parliament has Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. Similarly, as a part of federal aspect, we expect those to have Article 169 of Indian Constitution. What is Article 169 of Indian Constitution empowers states to have bicamerals. That means another house. So, if at all a state like, let's say, Telangana has bicameral, Andhra Pradesh has bicameral, Karnataka has no bicameral. Totally, how many states are? Supposed to be 6, but Jammu and Kashmir recently gone up, so 5 states now.
No, sir, now only 6 states.
Six states. Thank you. 6 states total. Bihar, Maharashtra, Karnataka, AP, Rajasthan, Telangana. Totally 6 states. Supposed to be 7, you're right, but Jammu and Kashmir recently got a union status. So it has become the second entity to have its own legislature. Third entity to have its own legislature, by the way. Okay, let's coming over the story is that if at all you want to create a state or you want to create a house, second house, or you want to abolish a house, it should be passed where? In parliament. But the initiation should be done where? In the state legislature. So state legislature, the simple majority, they're going to pass it. And that's, sorry, spell majority, they're going to pass it. The same is going to be passed with what? In the simple majority in the Lok Sabha. Sorry, in the parliament. And that will lead to what? Either creation or abolition. So legislative councils are created by the parliament on the basis of population of the state. The Constitution of India mandates for creation of legislative council in every state of the country. So Article 169, if you observe, not in every state, by the way, the Constitution of India mandates, not the Constitution, it's the Parliament has given a power. So Parliament has a power to create it or abolish it, not the Constitution. At present, 6 states in the country have legislative councils. Clear? So what's the answer, by the way? 3 only. You have the answer? 3 only. Legislative councils are created by the Parliament on the basis of population of the states.
It's not on the
basis of population, by the way. I'm so sorry.
Because it is based on the strength of legislative assembly.
Okay. Look at the legislative assembly. What's the strength of legislative assembly?
1/3 of total strength of
legislative assembly. Na. Minimum 60.
Minimum 60, minimum 5.
And what's the strength of legislative council? 40. Minimum 40. Maximum is? 1/3 of? Legislative assembly. So at any point of time, the population is not a criteria over here. Clear? It depends upon the state's interest only. Fine. Okay. Thank you. So question number 11 talks about what? Sun, corona. Consider the following statements. The corona is hotter than the surface of the sun. What is the corona, by the way? Core of the sun.
Outer layer of the sun.
In fact, the radiation part is what you call corona. The outer layer you see. What are the layers of sun, by the way?
Photosphere, chromosphere, and corona.
Corona is what you see outside. What is the inside part, what you call? Inside one. The core of the sun, what you call? You look at the sun, if you observe the core part, the zone is going to be a radiative zone and then connective zone. Out part, if you observe the photosphere, chromosphere, this out part, if you see, can you see here? Corona, yes. This part, the energy level, if you see, the radiation part, this what you call corona. Corona. Clear? So remember the sunspot cycle, sunspots. The corona is hotter than the sun, surface of the sun. In fact, if you look at the surface, I think it's about somewhere around what the surface of the sun? Internal is what? How much? Sorry. Outside is 6000 degrees centigrade. That is equal to the core of Earth. The core of Earth is what? 6000 degrees centigrade, which is equal to the outside. So I think the corona part is going to be very highly because of what? The accumulation of this energy, world energy. The corona gives rise to the solar wind. The winds are going to happen because of the movement of it. So corona is going to be more that. The corona is going to be radiation partner, give rise to solar wind? The answer is yes, both are true. One and two are correct.
So, how is corona hotter than the surface of the sun?
Because being the outside location, maximum radiation is going to be seen there. Might be because of a conduous... Okay, we can say this statement. The surface of the skin may have this what? The certain cooling areas, so-called dark spots. Dark spots. Now, when the sunspot cycle is happening, what happens? Hot is moving from the cold. So, comparably, if you observe there is a little energy or little heat, you're going to see there. Like, see here the statement. Can you see the dark parts here? Can you see the dark parts here? So, these dark parts are the cooling, somewhat lesser cool areas than the hot areas. On the other end, if you observe the corona, which is going to be very wider. Now, that's what the key says. Okay. Can you just select that, find the answer called corona. What is corona? It's because of solar winds.
The exact mechanism is to
hot ionized gas, you want to see that, that's the reason he says. Because of the presence of what? Hot ionized gas.
And
the
magnetic field of the sun.
Why it is in use, by the way? Because of the NASA's Parker Solar Probe. Recently identified the corona intensity, how it is going to be changed. Question 12 talks about what delimitation of conscience is. Remember what is delimitation?
NASA matrix is a part of heat packets that will release from the sun's core and it travels to the corona and then it gets explodes
there. This and that will lead to what?
This is the possibility through IRIS mission they found. NASA's IRIS mission.
Okay. Okay.
And they are yet to be explored.
Inside the mystery.
Mystery. But this is the possible. I think it's a hypothesis.
Yeah, no one can reach near that, right? So, not possible. Okay, question 12 talks about our Indian polity and that talks about what delimitation of consciences. Remember, in our country we have, in Lok Sabha we have 552 seats, by the way, Lok Sabha seats. Now, if at all you want to categorize one constituency, you need a body to do that one, and that body is created by parliament, and the act is called Delimitation Act. This Delimitation Act is passed by the parliament. I repeat, it's not a constitutional body, it is a statutory body. So parliament creates that body and parliament gives the power to the Delimitation Commission to draw the constituencies, to decide which fits in the also draw for the MLA constituency and also MP constituency. Not only that, it also tell you what constituency is the reserved constituency. That's a woman constituency, SC constituency, ST constituency. Once it decides, you can't even question that in the Supreme Court. Are we clear? So it is very believed that people strongly believe that it has to do with Election Commission. No. Election Commission is a constitutional body. It has only job to conduct the elections. Conduct the elections, recognize the parties. And in fact, Election Commission has no right to de-recognize the parties also. He has no right. Supreme Court has to do that one. So the answer is over here, delimitation is carried by Election Commission, right or wrong? It is a very wrong statement because it is done by the Act of Parliament and the body is called Delimitation Commission. The Parliament enacts a Delimitation Act every census. Is every census? If it's every census, it has to be any time, but it depends upon the interest of the Parliament. There is no census. And by the way, when you take census into consideration, It's the parliament who will decide whether to do it or not. So far, if not wrong, it has been 5 times. The limitation?
Election commissioners?
Who are at the election commissioners?
Oh, I don't know about this one. I'm listening first time. Is that true?
I'm asking.
No, not at all. Delimitation commission is statutory body. How do you expect a constitutional person to come in the statutory body? Violation of the rule against the law, right? Administrative structure is going to be damaged. So, delimitation commission is going to be experts of the government. They are going to be IAS officers for sure. IAS officers only. But these people are going to work better. So, strictly speaking, they work along with you, along with the election commission, but not with the election commission. It's not going to function together. The parliament enacts a delimitation act after every census. It's not every census, by the way. It depends upon the parliament's interest. But there was no decent delimitation commission. It was long back in the 1970s only. I think we have the data. So if you look at the recent data, why it was in news after the Article 370 was abrogated, Jammu and Kashmir got a UT status and Ladakh being a UT status. So they want to draw the boundaries. That's how the delimitation commission was on the picture once again. Okay. Question 13 talks about what? Transgender rights bill. This recently in the news, though the transgender rights bill 2018 was tabled, it was not passed. Dissatisfied again, 2019 bill was passed, no, on tabled by the way. Why it was in reasons? What was the reason for the debate? Before the bill was introduced, the cabinet has assured, sir.
The composition of delimitation commission includes retired Supreme Court judge, mm-hmm. election commissioner, respective state election.
Chief Election Commissioner, I'm listening first time. Where do you find the data?
It's on website.
Really?
And it also mentioned under Article 82, the Parliament can accept the
Immigration
Act after every census.
After every census, it's mentioned there?
Yes.
Okay, can we do this? Just a minute, we'll do an exercise here. So what the statement says, the delimitation is carried out by the election commission. So it is utterly a wrong statement. So if you take that statement into consideration, the parliament enacts delimitation act after every census. But it happened only in the
parliament has to enact, government has to not continue. But parliament
after 2011, there was no act actually, there was no enactment.
Because I think
that
is only a role in parliament.
Enacts is actually very not a compulsory statement. It's like a thing, but there is no rule that after every census has to be done. Yeah, just give me some time. Okay, I'll be finding it. For sure, we need to focus on this area. Another question talks about what a transgender's right bill. By the way, who is a transgender? Transgender. We call LGBTQ now.
A person who has the.
We're talking about whom? Transgenders.
Who is not just sexually attracted to the same gender, but exhibits the behavior of the other gender also.
Lesbian, gay, bisexual is more about what? Emotional feelings. Transgender is more a physical change completely. Completely change. In the election, electoral voter ID card, you will see only male, female, transgenders or others. You don't see L, B, G. Because this is what actually more about your... Okay, let me say this statement. LGBT, you say, you are deciding your partner. Transgender is that self. Whom you want your partner, LGBT, LGBT, you say. But what you want to be is called transgender. In India, I can recognize you as a transgender. I'll recognize you whether you are a male or female or transgender. But I won't give you power to choose your partner. That means you have no right to choose your sex, but you can choose your... And you don't have a right to choose your sex partner, but you can right to choose sex. There was a debate prevailing from long time. But recently, Supreme Court gave permission. So that's what now you say that. You can choose your sex, you can also choose your sex part. In a transgender, what referee means that is a sex aspect here. What gender you are? Are you male or female or transgender? Are we clear? It's not so easy to explain, but that's how you need to have a clarity on. What the cabinet has come with initiation, that 2018 was not a successful one because most of the transgenders are deprived of many, many schemes and policies. They are not considered to be a part of beneficiaries. Second aspect is about even the health aspect is completely ignored for them. The best is HIV. HIV, if you want to be eligible of that, either you have to be male or female, transgenders are completely ignored of it. And anyone who attacks a transgender, punishment has to be severe. The bill says that it has to be minimal punishment only. And the bill was not passed and now came to what? Second bill called 2019 bill. To mitigate the stigma, discrimination and abuse against the transgender. There is a mitigation. I repeat, the word mitigation is there. But there is no clear clarity what is going to be the punishment. For example, if a sexual harassment happens on a transgender, you cannot punish him under this act. You should only punish him in the IPC, so-called 367. I think 367, I believe, the act. So it's considered to be under rape only. But rape has to be openly proved that. So if you come to transgender, what happens? The law IPC may not fit that requirement. That's a one kind of a disappointment for the transgenders. What they say is that don't include IPC section to punish them. Include a section here itself, not mentioned here, to bring transgender into mainstream of society and make them productive members. Statement is clear, but the stigma is still continuous among them. Many schemes are not beneficiary for them. They're not considered to be part of beneficiaries. To bring great accountability of all stakeholders dealing with the transgender persons and make them more responsive. So the statements are far better. But what the NGO, what is that NGO?
NAS Foundation.
They always come with saying that we want more comprehensive policy. What they say is that why they are rejecting the power reasons for that? A bill is silent on the granting reservations to transgender. Please remember, in our country, we give reservation based on what? Social, economically backwardness, not basing on the, what do you call this one? It's actually, under Article 14, what you say that, right to equality. Under Article 15, what you say, no prohibition of discrimination based on sex. So how can you say that they want reservation by the way? The same story is 16 also, you cannot give reservation. But you can give reservation under Article 15, Clause 3, for women, precisely for women-based occupations. But how can you say these are women, these are transgender occupations? It's not possible. For example, air hoses or Anganwadi. So we look for what women requirement there. So if a government gives a notification saying that only women are supposed to apply, it's fine. But where is that post you can create for a transgender that only transgenders can apply? Not possible there. That's why what government is silent on that statement. Good observation, Rudy. Second one, a bill has prescribed punishment for organized begging. Now that's the biggest challenge if you observe throughout India or the other way. So number one, they have no first employment facility. There's a social stigma. And if at all they are seen like a beggar, so what happens? They'll be sent immediately under rehabilitation centers. The bill does not mention any punishments for rape or sexual assault on transgender punishment. They said there'll be effectively mitigation. They use the word what you call? Mitigation. So that is what clearly says that no clarity on what kind of punishment it's supposed to be. So all are the major concerns with respect to the transgender's bill. Okay. Then question, I think Karthik would be the right person to talk about it. He who actually works with a Cure group, by the way. Okay. On the aftermath of which of the following event, India first adopted no first use policy. Very famous, know that, but Pokhran 1 happened in the year 1974 that made Pakistan to be alerted. After 1998, what happened? We did a second Pokhran under the second was done by who? Atal Bihari Vajpayee. First is smiling Buddha, second is Buddha smiled again. Pokhran 2. In the same month, actually, when we did in the month of
May.
May 11th, that is what you call 11th May is called as National Technology Day in our country. Because Science Day, 20th February. Knowing technology, you apply the science, you call it technology, called Technology Day. So when we conducted few Pokhran tests for nuclear tests on the May 1998, immediately Pakistan did the same. And that's exactly After that, we had a Kargil war, 1999. So both states has, both countries have the Pokhran nuclear weapons, but we did not use it. And who won the Kargil war?
India.
In fact, India hardly used its all the forces, army, navy, air force. If at all it used all the three, it's successful. The best example is Kargil. In India, we used all the three forces. Coming over here, after that, what happened? Atal Bihari Vajpayee in the month of May 1998, he announced, we are following the same strategy of what China follows, what Russia follows. That's what you call no first use policy. What do you mean by no first use policy? We created nuclear weapon as a part of deterrence. What is deterrence, by the way? As a part of defense. As a part of defense. So our intention is not to create a bomb somewhere with a nuclear, but we always prove the world that we have nuclear power. We are a nuclear state. We use only traditional weapons if the others are using traditional weapons. But if at all any opponent uses traditional weapon, only nuclear weapon, you don't use first. Second time you're going to use a massive strike. Okay? So maximum retaliation. That means that's it. There's no scope of even the presence of the opponent. The biggest challenge over here is that this is illogical. The no first use is what? Illogical. Why it is called illogical? If someone applies, someone throws a nuclear weapon on you, do you have a time to retaliate? It's already damaged. But why we use that? We use to show that India believes in what? Yes, we are using it as purely deterrence, but nothing else. But a country like Pakistan, US, they followed no first use policy. It's called no first use policy. That means we can use any time we want. So which are more danger than what you call India and Russia and China, my friends? Are we clear? So why it was in news recently? Arun Jaitley, the defense minister, recently has come with a statement. What he said is the time to revisit, update the no first use policy. I'm so sorry. I said Arun Jaitley. Okay, it is Rajnath Singh who said it's a time to revisit that no first use policy. So, such kind of statements are not just going to be cool. They're going to bring some hot air atmosphere, especially. Okay. Then question comes about the 15 talks about what basic countries. I hope I talked in many classes. When you have a group called BRICS. BRICS stands for Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa. They have to do with what? Economy. You have something called basic countries. The basic countries are formed in 2009 as a part of Copenhagen talks, by the way. This has to do with what? Climate. And the other country is what you call IBSA. IBSA. Basic stands for Brazil, South Africa, India, China. IBSA stands for India, Brazil, South Africa. China wantedly missing. India wanted China to be outside because India wanted to be CHIPSA. But we made only to wanted to be IBSA because what is not with China, that is with the remaining three countries? Democracy. So they are polity groups. So what is economy? Basic. What is the climate? Basic. What is IBSA? Polity. So the question talks about what? Basic group. It is formed as a result of agreement signed by the four countries on 2009. Four or five? Four only now? Yes. It is formed to counter the BRICS countries grouping. Is that so? In fact, it's to counter what? The domination of the so-called Kyoto Protocol countries. There are some annexure countries which are putting a huge pressure on them. It is one of the several groups of nations working together to fight climate change and carry out negotiations with the UNFCCC. Right statement. So that's what you call, these people proposed a concept called what? Red Plus, remember? We'll talk in the climate. Sir will take the class about it. So the answer is what? 1A? 3. Question 16 talks about what? UN Resident Coordinator System. What is UN Resident Coordinator System? No, the name itself is very clear that certain agents or certain coordination has to be always created with the United Nations. So maybe the head of the state may can visit, or they can also appoint a coordinator who can keep coordinating frequently with UN transactions. So with reference to UN Resident Coordinator System, consider the following statements. It comprises all organizations of the United Nations system dealing with the operational activities for development. So any development aspect has to come with, there used to be a channel to communicate to that country, and that channel is what you call president coordinator system. Please remember, whenever you see the word resident, is in charge. We have a post of resident in India, you know that? Resident is a person who is in charge of certain operations. Like you say, you go to Delhi. For every state, there is a building, a house called Delhi, Hyderabad house, Madras house. And the head of that house is what you call resident. So resident is going to do what? Operations. He is going to handle the operations and communicate what is the Delhi to the those states. Similarly, there is a resident creation called UN resident. Resident coordinators are funded by and managed by UNDP. As a part of development aspects, my name is clear. You said operation developmental aspects, it's a UNDP, which are part of UNO. Both are right. Question 17 talks about what? Navroz Festival. Who celebrates Navroz Festival?
Parsi.
Zoroastrians, by the way. These Parsi people, have they followed two different calendars. You remember the Persian people who came to India and introduced this Navroz Festival. The Persian practices is what king by the name, Delhi Sultanate king by the name, Balban. Balban introduced this Navroz Festival in our country, my friends. It's a new year. How you have a Sankranti, how you have Onam, how you have a Gudi Padwa. Similarly, we have a, for Parsi people, what? Navroz Festival. That's a challenging year, because the biggest challenge with, I'll talk in the culture here. I don't want to go into depth here. The Parsi people will not follow the leap year calendar. That's why we cannot exactly say when they're going to fall. And that is the biggest challenge, is they have two calendars. One they followed by Iran people, another followed by Indians. Two different calendars. Clear? So, that was always a... They worship whom? Zenda? Avesta. Zenda Avesta is their holy book, by the way. Zenda Avesta and the fire. Okay? It is a Parsi New Year festival. That's the right statement. In India, Zoroastrian calendar is followed to decide the date of the festival. That's the difference between that country and this country. Recently, Iran has introduced the calendar. Sorry, is follow the calendar, but that is not going to meet the same calendar of ours. But the culture is going to be the same part. Question 18 talks about what Adi Mahotsav. Name itself very clear. Who are Adi people?
Tribals.
Girijan, remember? Adi. Adivasi, whom you call. So, Adi Mahotsav is seen where? It's a joint initiative, Minister of Tribal Affairs and Trifed. That's the right statement. What's a Trifed, by the way?
Marketing
Federation. Tribal Marketing Federation. Like whenever a tribal is going to use a small forest produce. Okay, forest produce, by the way. He cannot directly access the market. So, they create a kind of a government facilitator. It's called a Trifed, where they're going to interact with the tribals and they're going to sell it. Remember, recently Amazon has tied up with the Trifed. So, Amazon is actually purchasing the products of tribals in India through this Trifed. It will comprise of display and sale of items of tribal art, craft, tribal medicines, healers, tribal cuisine, display of a tribal folk performance, etc. All has to be the tribal aspects here. Clear? The answer is what? Both? 1 and 2 are correct. Boko Haram is an insurgent group often seen in the news in which of the following countries?
Nigeria.
You know, if you observe the Houthi rebels, you look at the ISIS, you look at the Muslim Brotherhood, all these are one or the other way creating challenge in the Africa, my friend. You look at the international terrorist groups, if you observe, almost Boko Haram, one of the semi-radical sect, by the way, long back has announced their support to ISIS. Throughout the world, if you observe, almost including all the countries, even in the Malaysia, a few rebel groups, even in the London, some rebel groups, even in the almost African countries, rebel groups, they all supported the cause for ISIS. And look at recently, the fights are happening, the war is zone is happening in the Syria. Clear? Still, we can say that. Question 20 talks about single-use plastics. Recently, Modi has announced, right, what he said? On the eve of Durga Puja, let's kill whom? Mahishasur. It's called plastic. So, let's completely make India free from plastic. With that intention, they have come with, not completely banning it, by the way, by single use of plastics, by the way. Completely banning the single use of plastics. That also includes the chai, that what you drink. Why it has been, one challenge is being the one of the SDG goals, by the way. Number two, it is actually economically also, if you observe, economically is also observed, there was no proper packaging India, packaging section in India. Now what happens, a cheap way of producing, a cheap way of producing plastic can be done by anyone. So the government cannot monitor how it is going to happen. See that recently many IAS officers are going to the streets and collecting the plastic wrappers to show that their support, that single use of plastic is supposed to be completely eradicated. You look at some water bottles also, single use plastics, by the way. So what happens then, when you go away with this practice, then we can also create a new kind of a new economy, which is more sustainable economy. Okay. One thing is very clear, that it's going to hamper the economy to some extent. And if, for example, you know, there's a new innovation happened now. What is that company? I forgot the company name. They are now making the teacups. The teacups is made up of what? Wafers. No, matka. Matka is a very old practice, by the way. Laluji introduced it. So this wafer is a very interesting one. It's same like a cone ice cream you eat. You drink the coffee or tea in that wafer, you drink it and you eat it. But how better we can use that one? A place like Cafe Coffee Day, where they won't use a plastic, they use a ceramic. So we can accept that statement. But on the other end, if you observe like other areas, and that too, chai being a national drink of India, so we are accustomed to that. So the move is a good aspect, by the way. But how it's going to be successful, you wait and watch. Okay. And you know what is this? Plastic carries something called a carcinogenic factor. What is carcinogenic?
Cancer.
Simple, clear. There's high scope that, you know, if you drink a tea, you know, I'll be surprised sometimes. You know, plastic cover, they pour hot milk and serve in the hospitals. You know that? That's very pathetic condition in the government hospitals. Not all carry the flask. They need to have some other source. So all this lead to one or the other way. India is where you're like, let it happen. Chalta, it's fine. Okay. It will, tomorrow you'll be in, if you are not IAS officer, if you are a group 1 officer, group 2 officer, your pun will get the tea in that way only. He'll get a coffee or a tea, if you ask him, yeah, through a plastic cover, and he'll serve you and give to you. Okay? It will degrade or break down in the tiny particles after the many years, yes or no? The plastic layers, if you observe, though, the microplastics, remember? When do you call the microplastics? Lesser than? 100. When you call the microplastics, Pradeep? 40. 40 microns is what you call microplastics, by the way. Clear? It releases toxic chemicals which make their way into food, or that's what you call what? Biomagnification.
Sir, I just said that under 40 microns, plastic is prohibited.
Prohibited.
Yeah.
10 power, I mean 40 microns if you observe.
Then 5 microns is microplastics.
5? Micros, microparticles. Mm-hmm. Okay, just check it once possible. Okay, it's a previous question now. Quite ignore it. Focus on it. So the toxic chemicals, can you tell me the plastic pollution? Almost all the chemicals, carcinogenic is one aspect. Number two, you know, it also affects what the urinary bladder is, yes or no? Urinary bladder also, the issues. So it's called what? Food and water supply. If you, you know, if you take any plastic element, food consumption, and they're going to stay in your body itself for years and years, they're going to stay, and they're going to add more to the next generation called the higher food. Biomagnification, that is a very challenging aspect. So what's the answer, by the way?
Accumulation
is coming together, obviously. All the lead, cadmium can be examples for this. 21, with reference to the village voluntary system, CM Jagan has started this program in Andhra Pradesh. What is that program called?
Secretary?
Secretary? Please, they are different. Village secretaries are different. Gram volunteers are different. What he created is a gram volunteer, village volunteers. Secretary is there, my dear. But there is an exam for that. I am conducting, I am saying there is another group of team who is actually a volunteer. When I say volunteer, what exactly refers? Normally the post is actually called as a, there's a term. You're going to see in every panchayat, you're going to see the caretakers. For example, for every ward, you're going to appoint few people. Well, the job is simple. Their job is making the garments close to the people. What they're going to do, they'll be giving a rickshaw. So please bring rickshaw, but they don't use it. So what they're going to do, like a pregnant woman, they're supposed to take to hospitals. If at all someone have any concerns, petitions, they're supposed to be guiding them. And these people are somewhat educated. They can fill the application forms. And they're going to get a, what is the salary for them? Village volunteers? 5,000. I think 5,000, I believe. 5,000. So in this way, these people are going to connect the governance more effectively. Grassroots level governance can be strengthened. Clear? The panchayat secretaries, if you village secretary, if you observe, secretaries created long back, not now. It exists long back only. Secretariat.
That's what came in here, sir. He stopped the
local governance. You know, that's a major aspect of the local governance, where how we have a secretariat, by the way, here, the policy making. Similarly, we have a policy making with the village aspects. Now, my student also now been a clear the exam, by the way. So maybe I can ask him more what he's doing there. Okay. It will take a government, with reference to village volunteer system, recently seen in the news, consider the following statements. It will take government health services to doorstep. So what are the government policy schemes about? And recently YSR Kisan scheme is also released now. And also ITEST, even that has been. So these all people do what? They're going to line up all these people and identify the right beneficiaries so they can synchronize accordingly. They behave like a proper channel to get the services. Good aspect, if you ask me, why to create unemployment allowance? When you can use these people to connect the governance, it will help them. Some people say that why can't it be a corruption agenda, sir? No, administration has to proceed, my friend. It doesn't matter how better you create a ICT, information communication technology, there has to be some physical presence to reach people, reach them. Okay? So at least there is someone. You go to a bank, my friend. You go to a bank. Normally there are people who have still dilemma how to fill the check. How to fill the withdrawal form, you know that? Then whom they are going to ask? Strictly speaking, clerk is supposed to help them, but clerk is busy in taking Xerox copies. They are going to ask them, security. Sir, security, sir, please fill me, sir.
Similar to that,
bank mitra. So these are people who are going to make governance better, my friend. Good, very good, actually. Some like how we have a reception in a company, same way we are going to create that kind of environment. And these people are available. So it doesn't matter whether you come in 1 day or 2 day or next month or after month, another month, they will be available. And the good aspect is that they are not a transfer. There is no transfer for those people. They belong to the local area only. So irrespective, when you come after 1 month or 1 year, you still see the people. That's not going to happen with other people now. This scheme involves provision of one volunteer to cover 50 families in each village. I don't know this number, but still good to know that it's 50 families. Honorarium amount will be paid to volunteers. It depends upon the state's interest, and there will be definitely contract only. It's not a permanent asset they're going to create. So, as they're working, they're going to provide certain facilities. So, it's a good. But Jagan said, I'm going to make you like a leaders. So, definitely, I have aspirations also. Okay, tomorrow I may get a ticket, party ticket also. So, one or the other way, it's a good move made by the political parties are, if you ask me, a very good pressure groups, my friend. They will question the government. You are busy, I am busy with my own task, but there is someone, people who are taking the risk to question government, criticize them. So presence of political parties is very essential. Tell me which committee recommended for the presence of political parties in panchayat elections. What's the committee name? Ashok Mehta Committee, 1976. Four major committees, what are they? Gargia. Balwantra Mehta Committee, Ashar Mehta Committee, GVK Rao Committee, LM Singhvi Committee. These are committees you are important for your exam. Doesn't matter whether you write IAS exam or the lowest exam called VRO, they'll ask you these questions. Four committees, very important committees with respect to panchayats. What's the first one? Balwantrai. Second is Ashwin Mehta. Third is GVK Rao. S is LM Singhvi committee. Question 22 talks about what Bali Yatra. You know, Bali is one of the biggest trade fairs in which of its state, by the way? Orissa. Recently, Orissa has got some GA status. Any idea? Sweets majorly, three sweets. Rasgulla, you know it very well. Sweets, I am saying, sweets. Channapudu, you know that? Channapudu and then? Arasi. Three major sweets got what? Very close to Srikakulam, Visakhapatnam, they keep on going there. There was a recently good article made on this one. Not exactly Arisa, what you call here. Same kind of a combination they're going to make of Jaggery. In fact, for your information, they all three are served where? In Puri Jagannatha temple. Employment in the aspect there. Okay? Yep. Question 23 talks about nuclear energy conclave 2019 was held in which city? What is conclave, by the way? When you were going to share the clean energy aspects, how better you can, create a recycle mechanism, all this. Where it happened? It's in Bangalore. Which state has topped the Niti Aayog's first ever India's Innovation Index? Karnataka. Karnataka IIS, Indian Institute of Sciences, Bangalore. Clear? So, when it comes to southern part of India, that's something we can say, the STEM, science, technology, engineering, medicine, they are very good with the southern states. Southern states are doing very good with the STEM. So, Karnataka is a good one.
Large states
are doing very good with
economics.
What?
North Indian states.
They are doing
good in
economics. Economics, okay. Studies. Yes. Which state has become the first Indian state to provide maternity benefits in private education sector? It's been sensational, na? There are many institutions, Indian, there are state, there are unions. I know personally that private teachers forum, these privateers forum, Telangana privateers forum, these people are demanding, we need to have certain assured. Summer holidays are there, you're not giving salary, at least give some salary for us. We don't have any livelihood, what we should do in the summer holidays? So all these demands are happening from long time, but the first state to do such, at least a good move is what? Kerala. So Kerala has come with what? Providing maternity benefits in the private education sector. So somewhat a good move. Very good move, by the way. Question 26 talks about what? Tulagi Island. Why is the news, by the way, in Solomon Islands? Where is Solomon? Papa? New Guinea Islands. Okay. Why is this Tulagi Island is in news?
Was leased
by China. Clear? So it's been also had, it has an attack on these areas. If you observe, the Oceania is now slowly going to get in the control of China. So yeah, I can expect this question. Be careful. Question 27 talks about what? OASIS stands for Officers Automated and Structured Information System. Is created by whom?
Indian Army.
Question 28 talks about what? Shirui Lily Festival. Lilies, remember? Lilies. If you want to cultivate lilies, what kind of temperature you need?
Mediterranean.
I agreed partially. Yes, you're right, by the way. You know, look at all these Mediterranean countries, not exactly Mediterranean countries. You look at the Gulf countries, they are called Jasmine Revolution. They have the flowers, by the way, named after. Islamic countries are called after certain flowers. Okay, like the same in the Mughal Empire, if you call it, it's called Mughal, that means actually called. In Uzbekistan, you're going to some kind of the grassland, the flowers, by the way. So this kind of temperate weathers, if you observe, going to be seen widely in the northeastern states. So, is it tough to guess, by the way? All are northeast states. Had it been other way, you can guess it. So, the answer is what? Manipur area.
Manipur?
It's in Manipur. Okay.
Shuri Festival.
Shuri Lily Festival.
Cherry is in
Arbachapur. Cherry, C-H-E-R-Y. Cherry, you say?
Yeah.
Okay, might be cherry. But cherry, lily is a lily festival. Now it's falling here.
That is,
I think it's endemic lily, my friend. Just find it if possible. I think it's endemic one. What is endemic?
It's local.
It's a local one.
India,
X Eastern Bridge 5 has started between India and which country? What is X Eastern Bridge? What exactly it is, by the way? What is this bridge 5? It is? Army exercises. It is with Oman. Okay. Nashri Tunnel, which is in news recently, situated in which of the following states? It was also identified few tunnels are has been a gate passes these days for migration is happening. So it's in news, by the way. The Jawhar Tunnel is the biggest tunnel if you observe in the Jammu and Kashmir, Jawhar Tunnel. 31 talks about what India's rank at 2019 Global Hunger Index. That's very pathetic that the social issues you need to be considered over here. Though India is having a very good availability and accessibility of food grains, but still the hunger is still going high. When look at the hunger over here, we also take the consideration of both micro hunger, the chronic hunger, and the normal hunger. Chronic hunger is something that it's going to be within part. It's one of the intense part of your malnutrition. You're not seen immediately. But the best part is anemia. Clear? And the global hunger, who releases the document, by the way? This report? Who releases the document? Global Hunger Index? I think it's World Bank. Just check it if possible. So it says, I think the rank is 102. Okay, international? Oh, international food?
Global Hunger Index prepared by Wealth Hunger Life together with Concern Worldwide. IFPRI stepped aside.
Okay, IFPRI. World Welfare. Question 22 talks about what a Food Safety Mitra, SFM. Is introduced scheme what? You know, there is something called food safety in our country. What is safety, by the way? What is safety? In India especially, though we have availability of food, but what is the challenging is adulteration. So when you look at adulteration, if you observe, how can be tackled? So there should be one organized body under Ministry of Agriculture only. It's Agriculture or Consumer Affairs. It's Agriculture only. It's called FSSA, Food Safety Standards Authority of India. So it is called a Food Safety Mitra, where it's going to educate everyone what are the elements you should carry. And remember, there's something called AGMARC. Is AGMAR an aspect of safety or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, it is, by the way. Clear? Certificate. If you buy a toothpaste and the toothpaste has a lot of air inside that one, and so you can go to consumer code by then. Recently, consumer bill was also passed recently. Okay. 33 Indo-Japan air drill exercise Shinyu Maitri has started in which state? It's in the Indo-Japan, I think it's in West Bengal. Huh? Just check it, by the way. Shinyu Maitri. It's in West Bengal. Shinyu. I think Shinyu over here refers to what? Maitri is Indian word of friendship. Shinyu means what? I think friendship in Japan, I believe. There's a Doraemon, na? Doraemon. There's a character, I believe, Shinyu Walker. Shinyu. Shinyu.
Best friend,
na? Ah, Shabash. Okay. Question 34 talks about what IIT has impact with Exxon Mobil to boost biofuel research. Maybe important for your exam. It is with IIT Madras. Madras has very good with respect to biofuel aspect, my friend. IIT Kanpur has to do with certain defense technology, certain creation. IIT Bombay is for information, more about information aspect. You can do some little homework in these areas. Which state government has decided to organize India's first training and performance program for world famous Khon Ram Leela? Where do you see Ram Leela?
Gujarat.
Uttar Pradesh, no? Ram Leela, you want to survive? World famous Khan, K-H-O-N. It's not Uttar Pradesh. Ram Leela is a dance drama. Dance drama. Can you see that one? Khan Ram Leela. Uttar Pradesh, no? UP? Yeah, UP to organize of India's first Khan Ram Leela. Where you going to see the Thailand version? It's a version of what? Thailand. Which Indian economist has won the 2019 Nobel Economics Prize for study on poverty? Very important one. And what's the book he released recently? What's the book? He's now canvassing na. What's the book name called? Good Economics for Hard Times. It is Abhijit Banerjee. Abhijit Banerjee. Along with this, his wife, what's her name?
Esther
Duflo. I know what happens to economics. They go and they marry off. Same with Amartya Sen also, no? So, economics. Michael Kremer. Okay, share the Nobel Prize for the experimental research on the elevating global poverty. So good to know that if you observe the challenging, the first Nobel Prize in economics was given in the year 1969 plus 50 years 2019. So the 50th Nobel Prize was given to whom? An Indian. It's good. It's given to Indian along with a US and a French lady. Frenchman. US French dual citizen. So when Amartya Sen got Nobel Prize in economics? 94. I think it's 98. Atal Bihari Vajpayee was Prime Minister at that time. Just check it. Also, he got a Bharat Ratna in the same year. Sorry. Yeah, he got Bharat Ratna. Amartya Sen got Bharat Ratna. Question 37 talks about what? Which international organization has recently released its report on South Asia economic focus making decentralization work? What is it called? World Bank.
World Bank.
Because the report also been talks like how better the decentralization work is happening in South Indians, and the word they use the word called it is getting a hyphen. I mean it is getting eliminated from the word decentralization and focus more on centralization. So, what is the theme of the 2019 edition of International Girl Child Day? What's the theme, guys? It's about power girls. What is it? Girl force. Girl force, unscripted, unstoppable. So there is no certain stereotypes, no prejudice attached. When is the National Girl Child Day? It's 23rd, na? 23rd January. 23rd January, I think it's called the National Girl Child Day. Ethiopian Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed has won the 2019 Nobel Peace Prize for his role in ending the 20-year war between Ethiopia and his neighboring country. What is that? That's International Girl Child, you were saying. Last week it happened, International Girl Child. That's being National Girl Child. Okay, so there is something called Africa, my friend, Africa continent, and Africa continent has a seed. Sorry, something like a horn. This horn is what you call like a rhinoceros, you have a horn. Here you have four countries. What are they?
Somalia, Ethiopia,
Eritrea, Djibouti. So, this Ethiopia, and with which country this man had a talks and finally into conclusion, it is Eritrea. Is in fact it's a very message to us that if you are in trouble with your neighbor, you still can make the policy better with the peace talks. Now, only thing you can just put sideline is the vote bank. Don't use this international agents for attracting the votes. It happens. It's a part of it. Any prime minister or chief minister who does anything, it has to do attracting the votes only. That's what democracy refers to. So I am the rightful person that you elected. So help me again. So, if you comment on a person saying that PM Modi just announced a Balakot 2 attack just before Maharashtra elections are happening. They do, my friend. That's a part of the election camp. That's a part of their strategy. If governance has to continue, they need a people's will. People's will supposed to be always. So what we do? Vote bank politics, vote bank politics. There's a no, and by the way, who coined it a vote bank politics? Very interesting. Amen? I'm glad you know that. Yes. It is M.N. Srinivas, by the way. Okay? So, yeah? Okay. Okay. Alright. So, it is Eritrea, by the way. You know the capital of Tanzania? What's the capital of Tanzania? At least, little do homework. Tanzania, Malawi, Mozambique, you all makes border with one river called? Nyasa. Kenya? Where is Kenya? Is Kenya in the African Rift Valley? Is Kenya in the African? You already completed world geography. African Rift Valley is a part of Kenya or not? No, you have no idea. Sudan? North African part here. Okay. Question 40 about Pangeo Bugia, which is in news recently, is associated with which of the kind of animal? I don't know why you use the word animal. It's supposed to be fish now. Is fish an animal? You call it animal? It's a cold-blooded animal or hot-blooded animal?
Cold-blooded
animal. Not hot-blooded? Warm-blooded. Okay. It's a fish, by the way. What is special about this Pangeo Bugia? It? It floats like snake. Looks like snake. Can you Google that one? Can you Google that fish? Haldiram's, na? What is it special for?
Species of eel.
Ah, what is eel, by the way? You know that? Eels have very capacity of generating what? Current, na? Electricity, na? Clear? Eels are known for that. Question 41 talks about what, which union ministry has organized the 2019 SARS Ajivika Mela? What is Ajivika, by the way, who he refers to? Empowerment of the rural, especially handicraft areas, lands, this? Textiles. Who is the author of the book How to Avoid a Climate Disaster? Guess na? Bill Gates. Recently, Microsoft gave an award to Narendra Modi. What is that award?
Goalkeeper.
Okay. Swachh Bharat. 43. Who has been awarded the Indira Gandhi Award for National Integration of 2018? Three awards are important for your exam. Major exam. Number one is Rajiv Gandhi Kheralatna Award, the highest sports award in India. Number two, Indira Gandhi International Peace Award, by the way. And also, is asking UPSC, I'm not just kidding here. And also Gandhi Peace Prize. So, Gandhi Peace Prize is the only award in our country where you have a 2 crore, the highest, what do you call, the monetary, what do you call that one? Not grantra. It's award actually going. 2 crore is the highest one. 2 crore, I believe. Highest that, even Bharatatna will not get any cash, you know that? That's it, only award, just go home. No cash, that's it. What is the price for Nobel Prize? Cash?
9 million.
So they're going to maximum given to how many? 3. So equal share na? 3. Who is that former Nobel laureate who sold his Nobel Prize to clear his debts? You have no idea? Things are that way, my friend. Okay. Who is the oldest Nobel laureate in chemistry? And in fact, they are recently gone now. The oldest person, 98 or 99 he got. He's about to die.
98.
What is his name? He got in the which category? Lithium ions. What is his name? Good. Very good. Good man. Okay. So it is Shanti Prasad Bhatt, one of the person, by the way, who was also known for environment. Remember, I hope spoke about that Chipko movement. I think I spoke about it. Shanti Prasad Bhatt, I spoke about. He previously got what prize? He got a Gandhi Peace Prize. Now he got a Indira Gandhi Award. Indira Gandhi Award in 2017, if I'm not wrong, got for whom? Asked in 2017 prelims, 18 prelims question. Who got Indira Gandhi Peace Prize in 2017? It is ISRO. ISRO got it. Clear? So questions are important for you. ISRO got it. Which Indian personality has been conferred to highest civil award of Comoros? Always, na? Whoever goes, it's not a Modi. It is Naidu went there, na? So as a part of, so highest civil award of Comoros. Good, know that awards. The Suman initiative has been launched for which purpose, Suman? Suman is for what? What does Suman stands for? Can you Google that? The word Suman stands for? Surakshit Matratva Ashwasan. Suman. This has to do with what, by the way? Healthcare, na?
Healthcare.
It's about a quality healthcare. Then comes the first ever India International Cooperative Trades Fair. Now, first is always important for your preparation. So, International Cooperative Trade Fair happened where? Always happens where? I think it's Delhi, na? No? It's in Pune. Okay. Question 47 talks about what? Which space agency has launched an Icon satellite to explore where air meets space? What do you call that zone, by the way? Air is meeting the space. What do you call that sphere? Tropo. Air meeting space, right? No. Air is less than that. It's called exosphere. It's called exosphere. That area is what you call NASA. So there is no ending for exosphere because it ultimately meets with what? Space. Exosphere. Okay. Question 14 talks about New Delhi, no? Yes. So it's not Pune. It's what? New Delhi. In fact, cooperatives were a brainchild of what person, cooperative banks, you observe. It's Pattabhi Sitaramaya only, Andhra Bank founder. Cooperative movements are well, not founder, but it's a Gandhian thought, cooperatives is. Article 43b talks about what? Formation of cooperative societies. Okay. Yeah. Which satellite based advisory service has been launched for deep sea fishermen? Is named after a zodiac sign?
I think
it's Gemini. Gemini. Sorry. Aquarius, not Gemini. Gemini is. This is what? Whom? Aquarius?
Fish.
It's named after. Not exactly fish. Pieces is fish. Aquarius is something you drop water. Na? A fisherman is going to drop water like that. It's going to look. It's named after that. Question 14 talks about what? Which union ministry has launched a month-long exploratory open water rafting expedition Ganga Amantran Abhiyan? The 2019 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine has been awarded for discovering which field?
Cancer.
It's about oxygen supply, how the respiration happens, not about cancer, my dear. It's about what? You can see Nobel Prize is for award for how cells sense and adapt the oxygen availability. So it's about what? Respiration. You know, there is something what you call a brain dead. Brain dead. It is proved that actually if you can make the brain cells function, it's not dead. So even after a brain dead, you can recover them if you know how the proper respiration. Landmark contribution, seriously. Today we may not know the worth of that, but people who are in that field, they'll really see as a So these are all the 50 questions, my friends. We'll meet